Immersive and interactive technologies are increasingly all around us. Here at List, we try to make sure that these technologies can be used by people to ultimately improve their quality of life and also to enhance the economy. Among the technologies we use are virtual and augmented reality, for example, to help first responders or the military inside radioactive incidents, or, for example, in industrial settings. We also use large-scale displays, for example, to look at data visualization and also to help people collaborate more effectively. Among the visualization techniques that we look at are ways to help scientific researchers inside the medical domain and also inside the field of anti-money laundering. Other laboratories we have look at, for example, the automotive sector and how automated vehicles and humans interact. And finally, also looking at the Cognitive Environments Lab, where we look at collaboration techniques using, for example, tangible tables. Here in the car lab, we test how people respond to different levels of vehicular automation to understand, for example, how their skills degrade over time if they're not driving so much, or how they respond to takeover requests when the vehicle gives back control. Other research we undertake with car simulators includes looking at how we can improve the competitiveness of companies who are involved in the automotive sector. Here in the Mixed Reality Lab, we undertake research on augmented and virtual reality, for example, in training people how to respond to radioactive incidents or for maintaining machines in industrial settings. An example you can see here, this is a training environment for military and first responders for radioactive incidents. In the scene here, a virtual and completely safe radiation source is placed in the scene, and with a combination of visualization techniques, you can see where the radiation is placed, which you wouldn't normally be able to see in real life. As a trainee walks around, they can interact with the scene using a handheld radiation detector, and as they approach the virtual source, the radiation readings increase. Other areas of work that we undertake here also involve, for example, connecting virtual and augmented reality together to explore this in entertainment or museum or exhibition type settings. One major topic for us is to explore how people collaborate in remote settings, for example, between different locations. We explore collaboration ultimately to improve the decision-making capacities of people in industry, education, or even personal settings.